Welcome back, everyone, to HalloweenHaunts365.com, the podcast. I'm Jared.
Hi, I'm Terry.
We had a fun night last night. You can see our little border getting into the St. Paddy's Day stuff. I mean, I'm probably 100% Irish, the last name Haggerty. But yeah, so we're going to start off with talking about the Horror Shed podcast, just did our 27th episode. So that'll air when this airs. So once you get done here, head over there. Got a lot of cool episodes, but here's this kick-ass video. It's fading away from me. I'm over you. All right, we're going to start off with some quick news before we get into our St. Paddy's Day coverage from Field of Screams. Had a fun night, huh?
I did have a fun night.
It was a blast. It was fun getting together. It was fun seeing everyone. Got to talk Jim's ear off. But let's get into some news. First up, we have Six Flags. Their Scream Break is actually coming to multiple Six Flags. Newly released. We will have one in Jackson, New Jersey.
That is awesome.
So if it follows the same, there's going to be like five or six rides open. Then you have three scare zones and two haunted walkthroughs. So, I mean, for $40 with all the food there and everything, it's kind of worth it.
Yeah, it's not bad.
We'll have to see how the dates work and see if we can get a weekend up there and cover it. But, I mean, it's something different. Something different for the haunt industry, and I'm excited. The biggest news
is
coming out of Transboro. We were actually one of the first to see it, which was pretty cool, and it blew up our Instagram. Immediate release from Transworld, March 17th, 2023. New Haunters Convention coming to the East Coast in 2024. Transworld to produce a new Haunters Convention on the East Coast in the Philadelphia region.
So awesome.
Who's in the Philadelphia region? We are!
It's so awesome.
It'll be interesting to see what they do and where they go.
I hope it goes to Oaks.
Oaks is big enough to handle it. We'll see. Hopefully they stay out of the city because that could be a nightmare. But they deal with St. Louis, so
right.
Who knows? Transworld is happy to debut a new show for Haunters and Halloween enthusiasts in April 2024. Transworld's East Coast Haunters Convention is a regional show for all ages and will be dedicated to all haunters, actors, enthusiasts, home and pro haunters, and anyone who loves to celebrate Halloween. This show will be the newest addition to Transworld's annual offering and will join the regional division alongside Midwest Haunters Convention. Plans are well underway for educational offering, a vendor show floor, special events, as well as haunted house tours, which will spotlight top professional haunted attractions in the Northeast each year. And there's a plenty.
Yeah.
Now, did we take this tour? Because we pretty much did them all. Oh.
I would still do it.
We'll see. It'd be fun to do it with everybody else. Premier show sponsorship. It's already been secured by Froggy's Fog. No shit. This is a quote from Randy Bates. I am really looking forward to hosting and participating in this inaugural show. This is sure to be the premier haunted house convention on the East Coast. This is truly a tremendous opportunity all around. Correct.
Yes.
This is from Goose Ride Productions, Michael Chalet. I'm really looking forward to growing my business further into the East Coast. I've been to all the industry shows over the course of my career. They just don't have the same impact on my business like Transworld. I'm always happy to participate in any Transworld show because it has proven results for the business. The next one is from Fright Props. Those who know us know we only do two trade shows a year. Well, in 2024, you can make that three. We're beyond excited to this brand new show and have the invaluable opportunity to meet face-to-face with our East Coast customers. Transworld has been a key part of our success as a company from the beginning and over the last 20 years. Knowing this new show will run their usual professionalism and zeal for all things Halloween makes attending a no-brainer for us. It's going to be an amazing opportunity to connect with friends and clients on the East Coast, and we cannot wait. Wow. Transworld has been producing attraction industry-specific trade shows for over 5 decades. In addition to the regional offerings, Transworld operates Legendary Haunt Tour, the nation's largest yearly haunt tour, which is this year going to Fright Kingdom, Haunted Overload, and the other one, Barrett's Mansion.
Oh, wow.
So you can actually even hit Salem while you're up there.
Yeah.
Transworld's Interactive Entertainment Show and Transworld's Christmas Show and Transworld's Halloween and Attraction Show. We have official sponsors here, and we've been to a few of them. We have Bates Motel, Reaper's Revenge, Frightland, Penhurst, Field of Screams, and we're blocked. What the hell is going on? We're trying to read the listing. You know what? I have the listing right here, ladies and gentlemen, because we were the first ones to pop it. All right. So Bates Motel, Reaper's Revenge, Frightland, Penhurst, Field of Screams, Frightmare Farms, Haunted Scream Park, Still Beast Studios, Fear Ticket, Haunt World, and more. And actually, Night of Terror is a sponsor.
Awesome.
So, pretty cool. We will be there regardless if we're pressed or just assholes that bought tickets to get in.
I know. I cannot wait.
I'm not missing my shot at Transworld. I'm not. And my question is, will this be a watered-down version? Because, you know, when you have all-shoot stuff, it never really hits, like, the main.
I know.
Kind of like sequels of movies is what I'm worried about.
Right, but it's still going to be fun to get there. But I don't give a shit,
because it's still going to be fun.
Right, it's still going to be fun. You're still going to get to hang out with a lot of haunt owners.
Actors. Aficionados.
Meet new people. It's going to be a good time.
It is. It's going to be fun. A lot of cool stuff coming. Can't wait for the dates to come so I can take the PTO, even if I'm still there by right. then. It is April 2024, which is cool because, you know, we'll have Christmas haunts, Valentine's haunts, then St. Patty's haunts, Transworld, halfway to Halloween, and then we only got to wait like 5 months.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the season's filling up. Our schedule. We keep getting asked about our schedule. We don't know yet. I'm kind of waiting a little longer this year because last year was kind of annoying putting the schedule together because you're just waiting on certain dates and everything. But I'll reach out to the ones that I'm worried about certain things, and we'll start working on that.
Yeah, we kind of start our schedule right after the one big one release.
Yeah. I mean, that's when our schedule becomes official.
Yeah.
Coming in with date, weather, and all that last night. All right. I think there's more news that I'm not thinking of right now. Yeah, I'm interested to see what haunt tour they pull together, because in the Pennsylvania region, good Lord. I mean, it could be their biggest legendary haunt tour.
Yes.
I mean, I know they've been up here for it, but to attach it to the convention to it and then that,
it's going to be big.
It's going to be very big. I'm going to be very broke again. Just stay out of Philly. There's no need. There's plenty of huge places right outside of Philly. Traffic's so much easier.
The parking is so much better at Oaks.
Yeah. You will not have a problem if you head to Oaks. That's what I would do. But who listens to me?
Be surprised.
Yeah, be surprised. All right. For us, we are announcing we are heading to Kim's Crypt for her Halfway to Halloween show.
Yes.
I figured it'd be a nice little change. We've only been there once. It'd be great to hang out with her. Probably meet up with the Haunt Review crew out there. It's kind of been our off-season gig.
Yeah, it was fun last night.
Yeah, got to have dinner with those guys. Shout out to Tim, Todd, everybody out there. The ones we missed that couldn't make it. You guys are awesome. We had a blast.
Yeah, Rich was there. Yolanda.
Mm-hmm. So that was a good time. And we headed into Field of Screams. And I'm already shocked. I really am. We're going to do the walkthrough, the scoring videos, and then we're going to talk about some of the changes.
Without giving anything away.
Yeah. Well, they didn't give me anything to give away. He's going to let me sit there. I love his little grin when he did it too.
I know, that was so cute.
Fucker. All right. We're working on getting actually the one of the co-owners of Field here for a live inventor. A live interview. It's early. We were at Field last night. We want to get this video up because I'm leaving for Connecticut for an entire week. Yay me. All right, but Field of Screams open one night only for their St. Paddy's Day event. Here's our thumbnail that you just clicked on. Look at that superstar in the picture there. I like that picture. It came out good.
Look, it did.
I turned our logo green for the St. Paddy's Day.
That's cool.
It is cool. A little something different. But, all right, let's get into the walkthrough. Here's a little, just if you've been to the Field, you know what you're looking at, but it's got a fun song that you can listen to while you're on the pod. Little walkthrough.
There was a lot of people there.
There was a weird walleye when I went widescreen, so that was pretty different. Hey, play with the shit. That's what we do. A lot of people out for a St. Paddy's Day event, as you saw in that video. From that video, you could see a new axe shed coming up. A little axe throwing action at Field of Screams.
Yeah, there was a line there too, which is really awesome.
People love it. I mean, it's really taken off. Check out Howler's Axe Shop coming soon to Columbus, New Jersey.
Yeah, they should be opening soon, too.
I got to get their logo so I can throw them on the website for them. I got Yellow Jim and Clarky. But, yeah, so they got the axe throwing. That whole corridor is normally food. Great food at Field. Then you have the five-minute escape rooms, which is a nice touch. The stage had, they were playing songs from the stage. There was no band, but the Dropkick Murphys were constantly on. So, what says St. Paddy's Day more than those guys, other than maybe Flog and Molly. But they're intertwined.
Fire pit was going.
Fire pit was going and crowded. A lot of people around that fire pit. Then we had, you saw some of the changes in that video to Den of Darkness.
Yes.
We'll get more into that after we do the scoring. All right, so let's just do the scoring videos. And then Frightmare, I just left at five blood splats for scenes, but it's obvious they are completely under construction.
Yes.
And a lot. Holy shit. I can't. Because one of the scenes looks like something that I think is going to really work for that, but I don't want to give that away. So we're just going to play the scoring video. We went to Den of Darkness first this time.
We did. We switched it up.
We did switch it up. How dare us? So let's get to Den of Darkness. Den of Darkness completely fucking blew me away, even for an off-season event. So many changes, reroutes, different scenes, brand new scenes, add-on scenes. Holy shit.
I don't think they're sleeping.
I think, I'm going to say it's 20% different.
Yes.
Right about 20%. And I don't know how the fuck they do that. And we were just there in December. It's March.
Yeah.
3 months. Why you're completely rebuilding another one? Like, it just, here. Like a moron, I decided to throw my hat and stop the recording while we were keep going.
Now hiring.
Now I'll hit the button. Now hiring at HalloweenHaunts365.com. A new idiot to do dumb stuff. But my hat does go off to that team. Crazy stuff. Let's do the Frightmare scoring video. I keep saying, I never really.
I don't know. It's early, though.
It is. Got a lot of stuff going on. I got to pack for my trip to Connecticut. That's why we're trying to get this out now so it can come out Monday. We have a cool video about the Haunted Mansion coming out soon, too. But Frightmare Asylum. I left 5 blood splats for scenes because the ones that are left are still fucking amazing.
Yes.
And even with all the plywood, we still had a blast. So,
oh, I know.
I was kind of worried about that when I found out about that, but Frightmare is going under some changes.
Even though there was plywood everywhere and the floor, worked. It still worked.
Great job out of the actors. Let's do the scoring video. I am the one and only soul that has no number above. Maybe I just alone. I trust my gut, but I've never let. You had done when you allow me to be all the things that I'm not. Well, it seems like I'm caught every time you remind me. You're right, take away my pride to burn it to the ground so we can start again. My crimes are left into the mind to burn. All right, so Frightmare going under massive changes. I said, I'm going at least 60% new. The whole basement level is going to be brand new.
I can't wait to say it.
Me neither. The mines there and how they do detail, it's going to be insane. I still don't know how they did all that they did in three months.
Yeah, December.
Less than 3 months.
Yeah, 3 months.
So hats off to that team. Great job out of the actors in there to still keep it alive and fun. And man, I can't wait to see what they do. Now I'm super excited. Some other changes you can see in the video for the walkthrough that there's some wood showing on Frightmare.
Yes.
They're adding, some more.
No. In Den.
Den. On the side of Den. They're adding more room for the projections.
Yes.
So they're playing with projections a little more. Be interested to see what they do. They're talking about having 2 different projections for each house. So that could be pretty cool.
What else would they?
So they're working on that. A lot of, like, Den's already, I think Den's pretty much done.
There's going to be changes to the hayride.
Yeah. We got some changes to the hayride.
It'll be exciting.
Be a lot of fun. I wonder what it's going to be. We actually don't know. He wanted to keep me in the dark, which was fine. And I wouldn't tell you if I knew anyway. But I hope it's that big ending part that they're changing.
Yeah, we talked about that.
That would just be me. That'd be my pick on what to change in there. But people enjoy
it. We'll find out in September.
Oh my God.
It's so long.
Yeah. So we're working on getting him in-house for an interview. It'll be fun. I have to cook him some ribs. I gotta get the smoker working. Maybe I'll work on that today, cleaning that thing out. Because I'll be waiting for this to post and everything. But yeah, we had some haunt news. Fright Maps is online. I'm actually helping him out repopulate it with haunt. So for the off-season events, we can start getting points so I can get my Freddy doll.
I was going to say, is it online? Because we forgot to check in last night.
I didn't
night.
Check. I didn't forget nothing.
Oh.
I was in constant communication with him last night.
Oh, gotcha.
We have to get the haunts repopulated. So maybe for halfway to Halloween, we could have a nice little list and start, you know, pimping that stuff for him. But yeah, if you haven't yet, download it now. Fright Props, you can set it up. You can earn everything. There's no money involved. You don't have to buy certain things. It's going to be a fun tool. And maybe we can start adding more home haunts to our trips back from the commercial ones.
Right.
Who knows? We'll see.
The app is awesome.
Yeah, the app's really cool. I'm looking forward to really pushing that out there and seeing what happens with it. If this is really low, I'm sorry, but I don't know. Maybe something happened when we switched when I hit the... There we go. What else we got? What else are we doing? We announced that we're going to Kim's Crypt halfway to Halloween.
Yes.
We got to figure out when those dates are. The interview with Jim Shaw from Field, we're working on April. And we're looking to continue interviews. So if you're interested, leave us a line. We don't care where you are, what you do. We'll talk. It's just tough for us because I have to be here. I can't do these I could, but it'll just look bad.
No, we'll just leave it for when you're here.
I mean, if it's something big, I can do on my laptop from a hotel with Wi-Fi. I've done it before, but I kind of like the look of this because I have full more control.
Right.
Haunt news. Everyone's working. That's the biggest thing. If you guys watch Reaper's last video, we'll bring it up again. They're working on their sixth attraction that's going through their engineers and the planning committee and all that. So they just had a little special on it on St. Patty's Day, actual St. Patty's Day. So I'm excited to see what they do. We're going to have them on soon. I want to wait a little longer, but I don't want to wait too long because you get busy.
All right. And they're going to be busy.
So I'm thinking like March through April, work on owner interviews. So, I mean, this is kind of a quicker episode. We went over some news. We went over our trip to Field of Screams. I feel nice and relaxed. We got to hang out with everyone and talk to everyone and give out hugs and everything.
It was fun.
Got some cool footage. Yeah, I'm going to probably just wrap it up.
Yeah, I'm good.
Next week, we will have another episode of Haunt History. We had Brian Copen come join us because I didn't know shit about the Haunted Mansion. I'm not going to lie. I'm not a big Disney dude. I don't understand the draw. But now I kind of want to go to Haunted Mansion. And then there's Star Wars. But before they acquisitioned Star Wars, Disney was for like stunted adults. Is like they're all little dark rides with like wood figurines. So I was just like, yeah. But after watching the walkthrough video of the Haunted Mansion, yeah, I want to go. Because then we could go do that, do Star Wars, then head to Universal.
Yeah. Maybe there'll be some cool houses in the next couple years.
Yeah, doesn't look likely. I mean, so far, the ones I know that are coming, Chucky the series, that could be fun. Megan, I don't care. No. Like, I get it, you put the movie, but it wasn't fucking scary, so how are you going to make a house? And then I know I believe Insidious is getting the house.
Yeah, I did see that.
They're all spec maps, but you can see which ones are real, which ones are fake. But nothing impressive. You want to bring me to HHN? Give me some from Freddy.
Bring back Freddy.
Freddy, Michael, Jason, I'll come back.
Yeah.
You do a Jason house, you'd be fine. Mm-hmm. It's just every scene Jason. All right, so we got the Haunted Mansion coming up. We're looking for interviews, so reach out. I have a line of people that I'm trying to get in communication with, but reach out anyway, because if your day works better than another person's, it could just work out that way. We're not doing, like, numbers or anything like that. It's when we can fit it. But this has been Halloween Haunts 365.com, the podcast. Our coverage of the news and Field of Scream St. Paddy's Day event. We will see you next week. Thanks for stopping by. Make sure you like, subscribe if you're still listening. Follow us on Spotify or Apple Podcasts, because this is where haunt season is every day. Goodbye.
Bye. Night after night.
Halloween Haunts 365 Productions.